Good morning, everyone, and welcome to SeaWorld. We'd like to thank you for joining us today, and we would also like to thank you for following the social distancing and face mask wearing guidelines while visiting the park today. This will ensure that we all will stay safe and will allow us to keep sharing these amazing animals with all of you. Please enjoy today's orca encounter.
Interconnected ocean, a vast blue expanse critical to life on Earth. And there's no better animal to represent the story of the ocean with all its splendor and uncertainty than the killer whale, or as it's scientifically known, the Orcinus orca. The orca lives in every corner of the ocean, from the Arctic to the Atlantic, the Southern to the Indian, to the mighty Pacific and beyond. This whale's story is the ocean's story, and it is one we all share.
SeaWorld's Orca Encounter. I'm Amber, and I'm honored to introduce you to this intriguing and majestic animal.
In every ocean, orcas living off the coast of Iceland are quite different than those near Costa Rica. In fact, there are at least 10 types or ecotypes of killer whales. An ecotype describes physical form, prey, social structure, and habitat. As you can see, the differences are subtle, but noticeable when compared side by side. Orcas are adapted perfectly to their environments. And even the whale's black and white coloration has a purpose. It camouflages the outline of their bodies in the water, making it easier for them to surprise and catch their prey. Of the whale blends in with the dark depths of the ocean. When viewed from below, the orca's white bellies match the brighter surface of the water, blending with the light above, giving them the perfect camouflage.
Let me show you some of their physical characteristics. the surface. Even the location of her eyes works to her advantage. It looks like they're in that white patch, but that's the visual distraction. They're actually located just in front, near the corners of her mouth, camouflage from thrashing prey. The fin on top of her back is called the dorsal fin. Dorsal fins help stabilize the whales as they swim and also helps regulate their body temperature. Dorsal fins have no bone or muscle structure inside them to support any height and weight, so you can see them curve. But the flippers on either side of her body are her pectoral flippers. Pectoral flippers have 5 bony digits inside them, just like the human hand. And they are used primarily for steering and stopping. The lobes on either side of her tail are called flukes. Tail flukes are the killer whale's engine, propelling them to speeds of up to 30 miles per hour, as fast as our speedboats. When they swim the fastest and use the most power, propelling their nearly 10,000 ton bodies out of the water.
Killer whales are highly social animals with a well-defined social structure. An orca pod is always led by a female. Though just half the size of her male counterpart, she is in charge. It's all about attitude, not size. Because they live and work as a group, orcas need to communicate with sounds and body language. Orcas use clicks for echolocation or navigation. Whistles to socialize in the pod. And calls for group coordination and hunting. Studies here at Seaworld show that early on, calves learn vocalization from their mothers. But as they grow, they learn from others close to them as well. This is a bottlenose dolphin call that Shuba learned and even taught other killer whales here at Seaworld. In fact, orcas are the largest members of the dolphin family. Whales here and in the wild use vocalization to communicate all.
Like all animals, a pectoral slap is used to show dominance and to get noticed. For example, a mother may use a peck slap to get her calf's attention. They really want to be heard. They breathe.
work together to rear their young, protect their pod, and most importantly, pursue and catch their prey. Every day they cooperate to survive in the wild oceans of the world. The orca's hunting techniques are as varied as the whales themselves. Norwegian killer whales will circle herring, herding them together. The whales use sounds to coordinate with each other and to disorient the herring. With the fish confused and contained, the whales stun them with their powerful tail flukes, making for an easy meal. In this example, we see the larger male orca surround a sperm whale, forming a perimeter, while the females continue to drive the whale forward until it reaches exhaustion. The calves then move in to join the adults in the group. Whatever their prey, killer whales always cooperate and hunt together, making them a highly successful predator.
Both in the wild and here at Seaworld. professional healthcare, research, and quality of life. Our whales take an active role in their own health and well-being. All of the whales are trained in a variety of husbandry behaviors, and behaviors will allow us to help keep them healthy. One of those you can see right now, where we ask them just to line up their body, and we can do a body exam and check everything out on that body. We can also ask them for their tail flukes, and our veterinarians can come and draw a blood sample from the vein that runs right at the surface of those tail flukes so that we can check their health. They'll also slide out onto a scale. We weigh our whales once a week to make sure that the youngsters are growing properly and that the adults are staying healthy. And they'll even allow us to get a breath sample from their blowhole. All of this is possible because of the trusted relationships that we've built day after day here at SeaWorld. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to slow things down just for a minute and introduce you to a very fun, very playful Nakani. Now, Nakani does seem to really enjoy playing and interacting with his behaviorists, as well as all of the other whales. He is a 7-year-old male. He was born on Valentine's Day, and he has definitely won the heart of our trainers. And we challenge our whales every day to learn new things, to engage and stimulate their minds. Diet, exercise, and of course play help keep our whales in great shape.
The whales here at SeaWorld have helped killer whales in the wild by participating in many research studies. One ongoing study monitors the whale's heart rate and breathing to understand how marine noise pollution from ship engines and other sources affect wild populations. In another study, scientists from NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, took measurements of the killer whales living here, including pregnant whales. By comparing these measurements with drone footage of killer whales in the wild, scientists are able to monitor the wild population's nutritional and reproductive states. Other research has been done here at SeaWorld on the mother whale's milk composition. This research will help create an effective model to understand how toxins in the ocean impact wild killer whales and their milk supply. What we learn from the whales in our care every day is actively helping whales in the wild survive. And just by being here today, you've supported our rescue, research, and conservation efforts all around the world. If we work together, like the killer whale, we can protect the future of the Orcinus orca and this beautiful planet that we all share.
If I could please have everyone's attention right up here on stage, we are going to start the process of emptying the facility, but we ask that everybody please remain seated. You'll notice there are park ambassadors at the corners of the stadium. They're going to empty the stadium out section by section, but more importantly, row by row.